Good morning, students. So, as you all can see over here, you can easily able to see the monkeys over here. So, what was the? These pictures try to depict you. Like you can easily able to see the small man, then early, then another man, then the modern man. You are easily able to find the different size and shapes of their structure of their body as well as their skulls also. Like you can here see the Australopithecus, they are having a big brain, and the early another Homo habilis or Homo erectus and the Homo sapiens and early modern man, you are easily able to see the therefore the changes of the human skulls also. So you can easily able to pretend like we are going to talk about the very millions of years ago. So my first question is for you, like where did they all get food from? Are you getting my point? Like these days in the modern era, we are easily go to the kitchen and ask for our mom and dad to give us food. But what about these early man? Where did they collect the foods? Either they are going to collect the seeds, fruits, nuts, or either we are going to hunt. So today's topic for the class 6. Today's topic for the class 6 is hunting and gathering. The food. Okay, so we are talking about in this we are talking about 2.5 million ago. So as I discussed about where did they are going to collect the foods or what they are used for that purpose. So they either go to hunt or they either gathering the food from somewhere else and they are going to collect the seeds. That kind of the things they are going to do. So what did they collect from the forest and where did they get the food? So first thing, they collected from the forest. Right? What about the another thing? Either if after the collecting from the forest, what did they do next? Either they are going to hunt for their survival purpose, what another thing? Yeah, we talk about the forest, they are easily able to fetch the food from their forest produce, or either they are going to hunt for their food. And what about the third thing? What they can also do for their survival? Either they are going to do scavenging. What do you mean by the scavenging? Scavenging means like the food was or the animal were going to be hunted by some another animals, and the early men are going to fetch that food for themselves. So we are talking about which era? We are talking about like this is the Australopithecus, then the human beings are evolving and evolving and evolving. After from the Australopithecus from to Homo erectus to Homo habilis, then the modern man will become. So we are going to talk about the Paleolithic age and the Neolithic age. In the Paleolithic age, they totally depend upon the forest things and the hunting or scavenging. But at the Neolithic age, they are going to produce something. Like you are easily able to see, they are started growing some crops over there. In the Paleolithic age, they are totally dependent upon the forest produce. But in a Neolithic age, what we can see? We can see that the Homo habilis or Homo sapiens are started growing crops.
So in, we can easily able to see that in a pelagic thing, if they are totally dependent upon the forest goods and if they stay for a long period of a time in a at that particular area, then they are easily like they are having the scarcity of the produce of that at forest goods. If and they used to do this all things like they totally dependent upon the forest, they are totally dependent upon the hunting, or they are totally depending upon the scavenging. But in a Neolithic age or in Neolithic era, we can see that the lots of changes were happening. But we can easily observe that they are starting growing the or they are started cultivating in the rice crops over there. It means their ideas of generating the food or the ideas of cultivations, they are easily able to grab that all knowledge. So in the ideas of cultivation, they easily get to available. It means they are having the knowledge of growing the cultivations, right? Did you all get that point? But in the Paleolithic age, they are totally dependent on the forest. But in this Neolithic age, they are starting domesticating the animals. Animals such as the dog. They are starting. So after they are starting domesticating, they started keeping the domestic animals such as dogs. After that, if we talk about the way did they live, so we can easily able to see in the lots of difference between the Neolithic age and the modern Neolithic age and the Paleolithic age. At the time, the people of the Paleolithic age, they are started living in nearby the river. So if we talk about the Paleolithic age period or if we talk about the Paleolithic group of people, where did they live? They are started living nearby the river. So question is for you that why they are starting living nearby the river? What was the necessity or what was the reason they started living nearby the river? So what was your answer? Okay, very good. So they are started living nearby the river because they, as we already know that the water is the necessity for our life. So here it was the first point. Water is very necessary for our life. What we can else do for the water? We can easily use for cultivation of anything, and we can use water for cultivating . We can also use water for a drinking purpose. If the as a human being, if we are drinking the water, it means the animals is also use water for the drinking purpose. It means where the water is available, the animals is also coming over there to drink or fetch the water, right? So after, if the animal is there, and so what I told earlier to you, like the people used to hunt the animals. So which place is very important to get the food for the scavengers or food for the Paleolithic people or the Mesolithic people or the Neolithic people? So they are started living nearby the water place because they already know about that the if the animals are thirsty, they are going to came here for a fetch of water, and they are easily going to kill that animal, so they are going to hunt that animal. Are you getting my point on? Okay, so. And if we talk about the what was the important end for the river, pond, and or the people, those who are started living nearby the rivers of in the Neolithic era, they are started making their house of mud. With the use of mud or clay
substance. Okay. So, what we have learned today, we are discussed about the Neolithical age and the Paleolithical age. We are also discussed about the early man's over there, about the early ones over there, and they are like, these are the Australopithecus and the Homo habilis and the Homo erectus and the Neanderthalensis, and after that the Homo sapiens will become. We can easily able to see the structure of the size, and the, we can also see the structure of their skulls, and we can also see that the Australopithecus is having the buck teeth, but after evolving from the Australopithecus to the Homo